In this video, we're gonna see how to make a boring render to something like this using Photoshop. What's going on, fellas? I'm Geo and this is Geo Creations. You can find me on Instagram as Geo Jerwin. Let's jump right into the video. The main reason for using Photoshop for post-processing is because it opens up the horizon of unlimited possibilities. This is where you can dump all your creativity. For example, here I made an interesting composition of an observation laboratory in the middle of a jungle. Just to make it more interesting, I've decided to make it as a research center for bringing back dinosaurs. Yeah, apparently, the research is successful. You can see some T-Rexes, some raptors fighting, brontosauruses, and wait, I don't know what is this. He'll be like, bruh, you don't know me? Okay, before getting into the topic, consider joining this small community by subscribing to the channel for new architectural content every Wednesday. Now let's begin with the 3D modeling using Sketchup. This is gonna be a pretty big structure because it's gonna handle some big boys, right? This is 100 meter wide and 125 meters high. I gave two observatory pods at the sides with glass facades and pretty much it. I'm just making this for one single scene. And for extra details, I've added an electrical unit and a cement factory. Yeah, it's a cement factory. Don't say that to anyone. For a reference, I made a hill behind this. For that, I used sandbox. I divided a plane into grids. And make it a rough resemblance of a hill. And using the subdivide tool from Artisan, I've smoothened the surface. Alright, let's take this to Lumion. And all I did here is set the view, corrected the texture, made the glass more reflective, applied the preset overcast, hit export. Okay, now the real work begins. Let's import the Lumion output into Photoshop. This is my finished file, and if you want this file for reference, you can download it from the link in the description. Let me turn off all the layers and let's see what I've did here step by step. First, let's search an image for the hills in the background. This image seems like a good choice. I've used the same image in three different areas. Basically, I created a masking layer and inverted by pressing Ctrl plus I and painted white only on the areas I wanted to be visible. I've copied the same image in three different layers, one for the ground, one for the rear side of the building, and I flipped the layer and I scaled it down for the background. Make sure that the images blend to each other and have a seamless transition. Remember one thing, all that matters while doing this kind of work is observation and of course practice. Here the lighting of this area is kinda off. It should be darker, right? So I've used the levels adjustment layer to bring the exposure down. To open this, press Ctrl plus L while selecting the layer. As you can see, the shadow should be more darker nearer to the subject, right? And it's pretty easy to get that right. Create a new layer in front of the particular layer you want to give shade. Press Ctrl plus Alt plus G to make it a clipping mask, and the changes won't go outside the selected layer. You can take a soft brush with black selected, and with the flow around 15, you can start painting on the shady area in a progressive way. Taking away the highlights, double click on the layer and drag the shadows of the underlying layer. Press Alt to split the slider so that you will get a smoother transition. And do the same for the highlights with the color white. And if you see, The main subject is not drawing any attention, to be honest, because it's pretty much flat and not a lot of things going on here. So I'm gonna increase the exposure of the glass facade, because brighter areas automatically draws your eyes. I'm copying the layer and creating a max just for the glasses. Now we can play with the levels. In this histogram, we can see that there is almost no bright pixels here. So let's bring the highlight slider here to the left, and now it starts getting brighter. Let's stop here and let's play a little bit with the contrast. And it's done. This is the before and this is the after. Now let's add a sky. Let's stretch this to our requirements. And you can see that the lighting is not at all matching. So you know what to do. We need to adjust it using the levels. Now it's almost ready, but it's still looking boring. Let's try to tell a story using this. As you know, it's an observatory for dinosaurs. We need to include some of them. So I placed them in random places and made them doing some random activities. Let's adjust their lighting using the levels adjustment layer. You can also tweak the colors by HSL adjustment layer. Give them shadows. Mask them a little bit off the ground. Let the grass come over a bit just to feel it's grounded. Give them highlights and shades in accordance with the lighting, as I mentioned earlier in this video. Still, the image looks pretty flat. So let's make it interesting. Before that, if you're enjoying this video so far, leave a like. It helps the video to reach more people. Make a stamp visible layer by pressing Ctrl Alt plus E. What it does is it merges all the layer and makes it into a new layer. Let's open this in Adobe Camera Raw. For that, make sure that the layer is a small object so that we can edit it afterwards. Press Ctrl Shift plus A to open Adobe Camera Raw. Let's tweak the lighting. To know more about the settings, check out this video by clicking on the I button or check the link in the description. Now it's looking pretty decent, right? Now let's apply some preset on it. Copy this layer and let's open ACR again. Let's apply a preset. This is a custom preset I usually use for all of my images. Let's fix the contrast by the levels adjustment layer. Now it feels too harsh, right? So let's reduce the intensity of the preset. Looking good now. If you want to know the step-by-step procedure to make this kind of render, check out this video by clicking on this I button or check the link in the description. If you watched till now, I'm pretty sure that you would have learned something new. So a sub to the channel will be grateful. Signing out for now. Catch you guys in the next video. See ya.